In this problem, we start with a car that's moving in the positive direction at 50 meters per second, and then the driver applies the brakes. And this is a fact that's so convenient to remember. If you have acceleration in the opposite direction of the velocity, the object is going to be slowing down. If you have acceleration in the same direction as velocity, the object is speeding up. I knew I had to draw A pointing the opposite direction of V because I was told the thing was braking, so it's slowing down. So I'm assuming a constant acceleration here, and I want to know how far the car moves during the braking process. And what we know is how long it takes to actually stop. So just making a little list of what I know and what I don't know. My initial velocity is plus 50 meters per second. My final velocity, if I'm braking to a stop, my final velocity is 0 meters per second. We normally assume the starting point in time is zero, and then we use a T for how much time has gone by. So that's 4 seconds. The acceleration here is unknown. And we might want to put an origin of coordinates at the starting position. I'm going to call that x equals 0. And then the finishing position we'll call some unknown x final. And that's what we're after here. Now this is one case where the fourth kinematics equation in the traditional list of equations is going to be the quickest way to get the problem done. So I'll show it that way. I'm also going to show how I used to do it when I was a student. And it's just because I didn't like to memorize more things than I really had to. So we have this equation that delta x, provided the acceleration is constant, is going to be given by the average velocity, I mean the arithmetic mean of the velocities, times how much time has gone by. And delta x is what we're after here. You could say delta x is the final x minus the initial, and that's just x the way I labeled it in my diagram because the initial position was 0. And the average of my initial and final velocities is going to be 50 meters per second. Final is 0 over 2, so the average is 25, times how much time has gone by, 4 seconds. 25 times 4, that's 100 meters, and we're done. Now let me talk about the way I used to do it as a student. And as a student, I didn't want to memorize more formulas than I had to. So the only kinematics formulas I ever used were the two that I would refer to as the fundamental ones. And they're all you really need because the other kinematics formulas are really just algebraic manipulations where we're combining the first two. And so the way I would normally approach this problem is to say, well, look at the second equation. I know the initial and final velocity, and I know the time, so I could get the acceleration out of this. Again, final velocity is 0, initial was 50. Right? I subtract the 50 from both sides and divide by 4, and I get my acceleration. And that's negative 12.5 meters per second squared. Again, the acceleration points leftward here, so that's why we're seeing a minus sign on this. And then I would plug that acceleration into the top formula and go x equals x naught plus v naught t plus 1/2 at squared. And I'm trying to find that final position. I put my origin at the starting position so that x naught is going to be 0. And I have v naught is equal to 50 meters per second. The amount of time that goes by is 4 seconds. The acceleration carries a minus sign that I'm going to move out in front of this second term and has a magnitude of 12.5. And then t squared. Crunch the numbers on this and you get the same 100 meters. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.